गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। सो टुडे इज योर साइंस क्लास, यस और नो? यस, ओके, वेरी गुड। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू स्विच ऑफ योर फ्रंट कैमरा एंड म्यूट योर माइक्रोफोन, ओके? सो आई विल स्टार्ट द क्लास नाउ। यस जोहिता, वेरी गुड। ओके, सो वी आर डूइंग विच चैप्टर? चैप्टर नंबर 4, यस, क्लोथ्स आवर प्रोटेक्टर। सो वी विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम द चैप्टर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल रिवाइज, हैव अ रिविजन, वी विल हैव अ रिकैप व्हाट वी हैव डन इन अ प्रीवियस क्लास, देन वी विल कंटिन्यू। ओके, चैप्टर 4, क्लोथ्स आवर प्रोटेक्टर्स। ओके, सो व्हाट वी हैव सीन फ्रॉम द चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 4, क्लोथ्स आवर प्रोटेक्टर्स, वी हैव सीन दैट क्लोथ्स, दिस इज वन ऑफ योर क्लोथिंग, इज वन ऑफ योर बेसिक नीड्स for the human beings, okay? Food, shelter and clothing. So among the three, clothing is one main part of your basic needs. We have seen that why do we wear clothes? You know why do we wear clothes? We wear clothes because clothes make us look smart. First of all, clothes cover our body, then clothes make us look smart. Clothes protect us from the heat of the sun, cold, rain, insect bites, okay, and clothes also help us to identify the job of a person, suppose doctor, lawyer, policeman, okay. Then we have seen what clothes we are wearing for the summer season, winter season and rainy season. In the summer season we are wearing light colored cotton clothes. Okay, this is very comfortable for you. Okay, and in the winter season we are wearing sweaters, woolen clothes. Okay, then in the rainy season we are wearing raincoats we are wearing because raincoats protect us from the rain and keeps us dry, and also it will dry up quickly. Okay, then we have solved the MCQs. We have seen that there are two MCQs were there. Number one, clothes protect us from heat, and we wear cotton clothes in the summer season. Then we have seen about how clothes are made. You know, clothes are made from the different types of cloth materials or fabrics. These fabrics were made by weaving the fibers. Then we have seen fibers, there are two types of fibers, one is natural fiber and another is synthetic fiber or man-made fiber. Natural fibers are the fibers which are obtained from natural sources like plants and animals, for example wool, silk, jute, okay, cotton, these are all natural fibers. Then we have seen synthetic fibers. These fibers are made by man, so it is also called man-made fibers. The fibers made from chemicals by humans are called synthetic fibers or human-made fibers. Examples are nylon, polyester, rayon. These are the examples. Then we have seen about care of the clothes. Okay, we have seen care of clothes. How should not only you have to wear your clothes, you have to also take care of the clothes, you have to wash it properly, you have to iron it, okay, you have to preserve the woolen garments and silk, cotton, expensive silk clothes properly. So what care we should take? See, these are the some of the carefulness we should take. Number one, we should always use a good quality soap and detergent to wash clothes. Number two, we should wash dry and iron the clothes properly. Number three, we should wash woolen clothes and with liquid detergent which are made especially for clothes. That we should woolen clothes for this liquid detergent. What can you use? We can use Easy. This is a very good for delicate and expensive woolen clothes. Gentle is also there. Okay, these two liquids are there. Liquid detergent is there for washing our woolen clothes. Number four, we should give delicate and expensive woolen and silk clothes for dry cleaning. Okay. Number five, we should wrap silk and woolen clothes in a cotton cloth and then store them with dried neem leaves or naphthalene balls. It will protect them from insects like moth and silverfish. Then what should we have to keep to store the woolen and silk clothes? What can we keep? We can keep neem leaves, dried. We can use dried neem leaves. This is very good antibacterial thing, material. Okay, antibacterial. This is the antibacterial dried neem leaves. Then another one is naphthalene balls. These two things we should keep with the woolen and the silk clothes. Why we should keep them with the dried neem leaves and naphthalene balls? Because some insects are there. Okay, some insects are there which are very harmful for these clothes. Some insects there, moth and silverfish. Okay. We should remember those names, moth and silverfish. Okay, these are the things we have seen from the chapter number 4, clothes are protectors. Today we will learn from the keywords. You know, keywords I have told you, keywords you will learn as one word answer. So what should we do now? We will do that keywords as one word answer. You can write down in the book itself, at the side of the keyword, you will write one word answer. Keywords as one word answer. Okay. So very good this one. So if I tell you fibers, one word or two word? Okay. Fibers obtained okay okay now Anay, you can hear my voice now? Am I audible to you clearly, Anay? Okay. So see here, fibers obtained from plants or animals. Fibers obtained from plants or animals. So what is the answer now? It is natural fibers. Yes. Okay, another one keyword I will discuss now. Fibers made chemicals by humans. What is the answer? It is synthetic fibers. Okay, you will learn this as one word answer. Okay. Okay, please, Shubhangi Chaudhuri, please switch off your front camera. Okay. So these keywords you will learn as one word. Other also are there. We will discuss later on. First of all, we will revise our question answer. We will do the question then. Okay. Okay, so now we will discuss the exercise of the chapter. Okay. All of you will do A, C exercise A, B, C. You will do in your book with the pencil. Exercise, I will write here. Exercise. Now we will discuss the exercise of the chapter A, B, C in the book. Do A, B, C in the book. You will do with the pencil, okay? Okay. See here, now number A. In the book you will do A, B and C with the pencil only. Tick the correct answer. Number one, we wear woolen clothes in. Options are winter, summer, rainy season. So what is the correct answer? We wear woolen clothes in winter. Yes, it is winter. Number two, silk and woolen clothes have to be protected from insects. Silk and woolen clothes have to be protected from insects like housefly, mosquito, moth. Answer is moth. Okay, you will tick mark here. So number three now. Which of the following is a natural fiber? Wool, polyester, nylon. It is wool, of course wool. Wool we are getting from the animals, sheep we are getting. So it is a natural fiber. Then number four, which of the following should be kept in between woolen clothes to keep the insects away? Is it perfume, naphthalene balls or sand balls? It is naphthalene balls. NAPHTHALENE. Naphthalene balls. And all of you must have the correct spelling also. For wrong spelling deducted. So you must learn the spellings carefully. Suppose naphthalene, NAPHTHALENE, naphthalene balls. Okay, so it is completed now. Now we will do the fill in the blanks. Okay, I am rubbing this one. Okay, now fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks. Also, you will do this in your book and you will write the answer in the blanks given. Okay, do not tick, because you know in the exam time no options are given in the fill in the blanks. You will have to write the word, so you will write the word there. Okay, see here, number one, clothes protect clothes dash us from cold, rain and dust. Yes, clothes protect us. Answer is protect. Number two, We were dash in rainy season. We were raincoat in rainy season. Raincoat. Okay. Number three. Dash is a synthetic fiber. Yes, nylon. Here options are given. See, if the options are not given, what can you write? You can write nylon, rayon, polyester. Okay, these are all synthetic. Okay, then number four. For proper care of clothes, we should always use a good quality detergent. Detergent, DETERGENT, detergent. Okay. So this is over now. Number C. Okay. I think all of you have done. I am erasing this one. I will discuss it once again what we have done today. Now number C. Number C. Identify the following pictures and write them in the spaces provided. See, you have to identify the picture. Number one, what is the picture? Yes, it is. Very good answer. Identify. Identify. It is moth. Number two, this is silverfish. Actually, silverfish is silver shown here black. It is not black. You can find silverfish in the very old books. If books are kept for many days, many years, most probably, okay, you can see that if you open the page of the old book which is kept for many years, you can see silverfish, silver in color. Okay. It is silverfish. Silverfish. Number three, yes, it is naphthalene balls. Spelling NAPHTHALENE. Naphthalene balls. Okay, this is naphthalene balls. So this is completed now. So what we have done today, up to this much we will discuss now. Okay, we have done number A, number B and number C from the book of the exercise. See, number A, what we have ticked, the correct answer. We wear woolen clothes in winter. Number two, silk and woolen clothes have to be protected from insects like moth. Which of the following is a natural fiber? Wool. Number four, which of the following should be kept in woolen clothes to keep the insects away? It is naphthalene balls. Number B now, fill in the blanks. Number one, clothes protect us from cold, rain and dust. Number two, we wear dash in rainy season. We wear raincoat in rainy season. Number three, dash is a synthetic fiber. So nylon, nylon is a synthetic fiber. Number four, for proper care of clothes, we should always use a good quality detergent. Okay, all of you must learn the spellings also. Remember, for spelling mistakes, marks will be deducted. Number C, identify the following pictures. Number one picture is moth, number two picture is silverfish, and number three picture is naphthalene balls. So, So that's all today for that's all for today. Okay, students. So I hope you will learn the chapter well at home. You will be staying safe. You will learn the chapter properly, and you will also learn what we have done today. Means from the exercise A, B, C is very important for the exam. I hope you will have the good result also. You will do the good result. So best of luck and good one. Okay. Okay, everyone. Bye, everyone. In our next class, we will discuss what we will discuss. We will discuss the short answer question. Okay, we will discuss very short answer question. We will do in the science notebook, means your science copy. We will discuss very short answer question. We will also discuss short answer question also. After that, we will able to complete very short and long answer. Okay, that's all today. Thank you, everyone.